Cataract surgery and low to mild myopia. What you should know about lens selection in these cases, what type of visual experience you might expect with different IOL types, and what you should discuss with your doctor before the surgery to be happy after the surgery. Hi there. My name is Alexey and you're at IOL-adviser, Eye Surgery Explained channel. First of all, let's dig deeper into the eye anatomy of low to mild myopia patients and the specific of their vision, because that understanding will be essential to understand future outcomes with IOLs selected for your particular visual needs. Well, what is the difference between low myopia patients and ametropia patients? So between the patients who need some minus glasses or contact lenses and patients who doesn't need glasses for their daily activity. The biggest difference is that normal eyes, the young healthy eye, is designed to be, let's say, focused to the far objects only. And for near objects, we use so-called accommodation mechanism. What is accommodation? I explained it a few times in my previous videos, so have a look to the description to this video to have links to other videos explaining it in more details. But generally, it is ability for our eye to focus on near objects. And if we are talking about young, healthy eye, the eye is designed by nature to see clearly to the far end infinity distance. And to see clearly, we use accommodation which changes optical power of the entire eye by changing the shape of our intraocular lens. It means that in to see clearly up close, our eye has to change its optical power to about 3 diopters if we're looking to about 33 centimeters. It is, let's say, very approximate numbers just to have an idea for you. And what is mild myopia? Mild myopia means that your eye is designed by nature in that way that your eye is perfectly focused at near objects. Again, I'm talking about mild myopia of about -3 plus minus 1 diopter. So it means that myopic patients have a natural ability to see extremely well at near. Depending on your myopia, it might be 25 centimeters, might be 30, whatever. And to see clearly at far, these people need to use far vision glasses, which are normally -2, -3 or contact lenses. The problem of that patients, or the happiness of that patients, is that they are designed in that way, they have extremely good vision up close. And due to the specific of the retina in many cases, they have extremely sharp vision at the far, of course, when they use vision correction glasses or contact lenses. And when it comes to eye surgery, when it comes to refractive lens exchange, if this people would like to get rid of glasses at certain ages, or especially if it comes to the cataract surgery to remove the cloudy lens and to implant the intraocular lens and IOL, it means that these people expect similar vision experience with the new lens, with the artificial lens implanted. And what is the problem here? The problem is that we don't have any ideal IOL solution which is able to restore our young, healthy, natural vision. So it has a lot of compromises, and we have to select among 4 major IOL types and about way more different lenses options available in your particular location and your particular clinic of choice. And in order to select the particular IOL, we have to go through the different, let's say, drawbacks, advantages and disadvantages of every particular model and every particular case. And in order to help the patients to understand all the options available, in order to navigate through different IOL options, types and models, I have created an IOL selection resource, which is called IOLadviser.com, where you can try automatic IOL questionnaire, which will help you to define, let's say, a direction what to discuss with your doctor, where you can read about different IOL models and to book my personal consultation when I can help you to understand all the options, when I can help you to be educated more about the IOL options, about the discussion with your doctor and about your visual expectations after the surgery with different lenses. And it will help you to discuss with your doctor final decision of the surgery and to get the maximum out of your sight after the surgery with particular IOL you have selected. Have a look to the description below to this video. You will find a link and you will find plenty of information at that website. And coming back to your vision experience with a mild myopia, you have a crystal crisp vision up close without glasses. And if you are young, you have the same crystal crisp experience with glasses to the infinity, to the far, as well at up close because you have accommodation. And when it comes to the surgery, probably you would like to be absolutely free of glasses, because cataract surgery, as well as refractive lens exchange, is a surgery which helps you to solve the two problems, or even three problems. If you have a cataract, of course, the cataract surgery removes the cloudy medium and it solves problem number one, is a cataract. The problem number two, the cataract surgery will help you to eliminate need of glasses for far vision, for any daily activities. And the problem number three, which you might probably be not aware of if you are using glasses, and you're definitely aware of that problem if you're using contact lenses in your, let's say, 45 plus age, is the reading glasses. What does it mean? If you are using contact lenses, you know what I'm talking about. With the contact lenses, you see good at infinity. But if you would like to read something, you start using reading glasses with about plus one or something like that to improve your near vision ability, because your eye accommodation doesn't work anymore. And if you use glasses, you simply remove your far vision glasses and you start reading, because your eye is designed to read up close very well. And coming back to the surgery, if you would like to remove all the issues like cataract, glasses for far and glasses for near, there are a lot of solutions available. So it is a kind of full range of vision intraocular lenses, or extended range of vision intraocular lenses, which will allow you to see clearly what will doctor say at any distances without use of glasses in most of the cases. And what is important to know in these circumstances? The problem is, coming back to your early ages, you had extremely sharp and crisp vision up close and at infinity with the use of glasses. And if you are talking about full range of vision lenses, like trifocal, let's say hybrid, whatever, diffractive optics, this type of lenses generally provides good near, good intermediate, and good far vision. But people with extremely sharp, with this type of supervision, as we call it sometimes, might be absolutely unhappy with visual outcomes, because if you compare your vision quality up close and vision acuity up close with that type of lenses, with your initial experience when you was young or you was at elderly age and you was using glasses, that visual experience might be not so good, and you might be unhappy in these cases, unless you understand the drawbacks of the technologies. Honestly, there is no ideal solution for you in this case. So there are just, I would say, three options available. The first one, as I mentioned, is full range of vision lenses. But you have to be ready that your far vision will be good enough. It will be 20/20, you will see 10 lines. But if you was able to see, let's say, in your young ages with the glasses, let's say 15 lines, don't expect that. So you might be disappointed with your far vision in these cases. Coming back to near vision. Again, if you was able to see a lot of small tiny details in your younger ages without use of glasses, because you was -3 and your eye was perfectly focused on the distance, with a full range of vision lenses, you will have kind of normal vision for majority of people. But you will not have your supervision up close. And it is kind of a bill to be spectacle independent at all the distances. The option number two, you might have extended monofocal or extended range vision lenses calculated at a bit minus, calculated at micro monovision, for instance. This option might give you a better far vision, better intermediate, but your eyes will be slightly different in terms of far vision acuity and near vision acuity in one eye and in second eye. And again, it is your bill which you have to pay to be spectacle independent and to have, let's say, different visual experience with that type of lenses. And if you would like to see extremely well for whatever reason up close as before, and you are able to and you are happy to use your glasses for infinity as you did in your early ages, you might select the monofocal lens calculated at exactly -3, for example, to be crystally sharply focused on that particular distance. And the visual experience will be the following. You will have a crystal clear vision in the at up close distance, and for far vision you will need the glasses. But if you put your glasses on for far vision, you will have extremely well far vision, but you will lose your near vision. So you will have to juggle with duty-filling glasses. So, or let's say you have to juggle without glasses at here and use glasses for far vision. And in some cases, you will need a glasses for your computer distance if you're using kind of a larger screen or larger laptop. So if you're having low to mild myopia, you are quite a complicated patient for any cataract or refractive surgeon because of your high vision demands you might have. And not all of the doctors are able to discuss deeply all the tiny details with you. Sometimes in these cases, they try to offer you the easiest for them solutions. And you have to be aware that you have plenty of choices. But whatever choice you do, you have to, let's say, pay the bill. I'm not talking about money, I'm talking about your visual compromises. To be either more spectacle independent and slightly reduce your quality of vision you used to have in your early ages, or you would like to keep your extremely sharp vision at certain distances, but in this case, you will lose your freedom of glasses. The choice is yours. Please discuss it with your doctor. And what is more important, not every lens type is suitable for every patient, because a part of, let's say, visual needs and desires and expectation of the patient, we have a medical history of the patient, we have certain eye diseases which might limit some use of certain lenses. And that's why for you it's important to first of all think about your visual needs, reflect how would you would like to use your vision. Again, you can use my website, you can use different resources, read something or discuss with your doctor. And at the end of the day, your doctor is the only one person who takes the final decision, probably with you, or sometimes if you have some kind of specific eye diseases, your doctor will say, I'm sorry, we have only one solution because you have certain disease or certain eye conditions. So be ready to discuss with your doctor your visual needs. Be ready to hear your doctor. And if you're a doctor, I encourage you to be open with the patient, to explain all the issues about astigmatism, accommodation, all the stuff, and be honest in terms of cons and pros and limitation of every IOL technology you are using. We all know that there is no perfect lens available. And we know that the only perfect lens for the patient is a lens which has a perfect match between the lens technology and patient visual needs.